same time, the implementation rules of 1985 laid down the condition that the arbitrator must not have any interest in the case, thus complementing Article 12 of the Saudi Arabia Arbitration Law of 1983, which puts arbitrators on the same level as the judges and makes them subject to challenge for the same reasons. In the Muslim arbitration law, it's so interesting, this case. For example, in the Muslim arbitration law, only men can be appointed as arbitrator, and Muslim, but woman has not been appointed as arbitrator. It's the reason is like Sharia. The Sharia, the way means the way. Sharia. The Muslim world has a different schools of law. Hanbali, Hanafit. No? Hanbali is Hanafi and Hanbali is interesting because Hanbali is so strong school, so strong school. But Hanafi is more soft. It's more soft.
Sunni Hanafi is softer
way. It's true. Thank you. The new Saudi Arabia arbitration law of 2012 expressly incorporates in Article 16 the requirement that the arbitrator does not have any interest in the dispute. Also, it can be inferred from paragraph 2 that arbitrators can be challenged for the same reasons as judges. We can see that the new Saudi Arabia arbitration law maintains the tendency of the previous arbitration law to regard the arbitrator as a judge. This is the most common rule. China, arbitration law and rules. An example from Asia is the Chinese arbitration law of 1994. This is another interesting case. Even though it mentions impartiality, it doesn't mention independence. Nevertheless, it's another case that establishes practical guidelines to determine the independence and impartiality of the arbitrator. This is the most important character of the China arbitration law in this issue. In Article 34, it states, in one of the following circumstances,